class 10. I believe that you have been going through the lessons that has been commencing so far, and you have copied down the notes that has been given from chapter 4. Now today I am going to start the new lesson, that is chapter 5, which deals with the alternative ideas, thoughts and initiatives. Now what does that mean? It means that the development of printing technology as well as the scientific education in India by the Indians. Now it is obvious that it was the Europeans who had first, rather the British who had first started these things in our country, the modern aspects in our country. But during the middle of the 19th century and the 20th century, the Indians had also started to take the initiative in this field. So, it was the Portuguese in our country who had first established the printing press in Goa. And from there, slowly it had started to spread by the British. In Bengal, it was James Augustus Hickey who had felt the need for the public newspaper in Bengal. And so he had appealed in England and asked for the permission, got the permission, and in 1780 he had published the first Indian newspaper in English language, Bengal Gazette. And thereafter many more newspapers had been published. Now from the very beginning, the British officials or authority in India, they were quite apprehensive regarding this publication of newspaper, public newspapers. So they had put quite a lot of restrictions. We will learn about them gradually, but we are going to start the lesson as I am going to give you the points. Mostly these points come as the objective questions. So you will write them down and underline the key words and then solve the questions that will be given by me. Now, let us begin. The heading, Development of Printing Press in Bengal. Under this, write down point wise. The first point, in India, the Portuguese founded the first printing press. Second point, the real founder of printing press in Bengal were the Christian missionaries. James Augustus Hickey first realized the need of setting up public newspaper in India. He established the first printing press in Calcutta and published the first weekly English newspaper, Bengal Gazette, in 1780. Charles Wilkins was the founder of the movable Bengali type with the help of Panchanon Kormokar. Charles Wilkins is known as the Gutenberg of Bengal or India. Next point, he published the book A Grammar of the Bengali Language by Halhed. In 1800, Srirampur Mission Press was established by William Carey, Joshua Marshman and William Ward. They are commonly known as Srirampur Trio. Next point, the first weekly newspaper published in Bengali language in 1818 was Bengal Gazette by Gangakishore Bhattacharya, Now, first newspaper, it is the first newspaper in Bengali also. There is a little bit of controversy which is the first newspaper in Bengali language. Some say that it is the Bengal Gazette by Gangakishore Bhattacharya, or some say it is the Samachar Darpan by Marshman. But usually it is accepted that it is the Bengal Gazette by Gangakishore Bhattacharya. Next point, in 1818, first monthly periodical was published from Srirampur Press by Marshman was Digdarshan, along with weekly Samachar Darpan. The first daily newspaper in Bengali was Sambad Prabhakar by Ishwar Chandra Gupta. Now, next point, it is a very important one. Adams Press Regulation was imposed to control the press in 1823. It was repealed by Charles Metcalfe. You don't write the year right now. I will confirm the year and tell you later on. Now, as I have already told you that there were many regulations and rules imposed on the newspapers published in India. So, in 1823, the Adams Press Regulation was imposed to control the press, and it was very much resented by the Indians, and so ultimately the British government in India had to remove it. And it was done by Charles Metcalfe. Next, John Andrews was the owner of the first printing press in Bengal. John Andrews was the owner of the first printing press in Bengal. Now, regarding the regulation on press, this is a very important topic. The Vernacular Press Act, it usually comes as a 2 marks question, that very direct question, what was the Vernacular Press Act? Now write it down. During the reactionary rule of Lord Lytton, a number of repressive laws were passed. One of them was the Vernacular Press Act in 1878. Which imposed various restrictions on the newspapers published in Indian languages. This act deprived the newspapers of their right to criticize the government. However, the political organizations reacted strongly against the act, and under pressure, Lord Ripon ultimately annulled the Vernacular Press Act. Now, next heading, give development of printing and growth of education. First point, the need for books was felt by the urban educated Indians and some professionals. With the introduction and development of printing press, textbooks of all kinds, both in English and vernacular, were published, making easy availability of education. The first among printed books in Bengali was the Barnaparichay of Vidyasagar, published in 1855.